Hello and welcome back. You're watching Parry This. Today we are going to be digging into another Crusades-related topic. Today's topic is going to be the Order of the Holy Sepulchre. This is the latest in my series of videos discussing monastic knightly orders that originated or in some way participated in the Crusades. I have previously covered the Knights Templar, the Knights Hospitaller, the Knights of St. Lazarus, and the Teutonic Knights. So, if after watching this video you would like to listen and possibly learn about any of those topics, I invite you to do so. So, without any more plugging, let's dive on in and learn what there is to know about these fine fellows. The origins of the Equestrian Order of the Holy Sepulchre of Jerusalem are generally thought to date back to the First Crusade, when the Crusade's leader, Godfrey de Bouillon, liberated Jerusalem as a component of his reorganization of the religious, military, and public bodies of the territories newly freed from Muslim control, he founded the Order of Canons of the Holy Sepulchre. According to most accounts of the Crusades, the first king of Jerusalem, Baldwin I, assumed the leadership of this canonical order in 1103, and reserved the right for himself and his successors, as agents of the Patriarch of Jerusalem, to appoint knights to it, should the Patriarch be absent or unable to do so. The order's members included not only the regular canons, but also the secular canons and the sergeants. The latter were armed knights chosen from the Crusader troops for their qualities of valor and dedication. They vowed to obey the Augustinian rule of poverty and obedience, and undertook specifically to defend the Holy Sepulchre and the other holy places, under the command of the King of Jerusalem. Very soon after the First Crusade, the troops, including the Knights of the Order of the Canons of the Holy Sepulchre, began to return to their homelands. This led to the creation of priories all over Europe, which were part of the order as they came under the jurisdiction of the noble knights or prelates who had been invested at the Holy Sepulchre itself, and who, although they were no longer in the direct service of the King of Jerusalem, continued to belong to the Order of Canons. The order began to decline as a cohesive military body of knights after Salah ad-Din regained Jerusalem in 1182, and completely ceased to exist in that format after the defeat of Acre in 1291. The passing of the Christian Kingdom of Jerusalem left the order without a leader, though it continued to survive in the European priories thanks to the protection of sovereigns, princes, bishops, and the Holy See. The priories kept alive the ideals of the Crusader Knights: propagation of the faith, defense of the weak, charity towards other human beings. With the exception of the events in Spain, it was only rarely that the Knights of the Holy Sepulchre ever took part again in military action to defend Christianity. In 1312, following the departure of the Franks and the end of the Latin Patriarchate of Jerusalem, Pope Clement VI entrusted the Franciscans of Mount Zion with the mission of representing the papacy in the Holy Land, but this religious community was only officially recognized by the Turks in 1333, when the King of Naples got the Sultan to agree, upon payment of 32,000 gold ducats, that the Franciscans could remain in Palestine and continue to guard the holy places. The prerogative of dubbing knights before the Tomb of Christ, in the past exercised by the canons, was thus transferred to the Franciscan custodian, who had the rank of bishop, and who alone upheld the presence of the papacy in the Holy Land until 1847, often under adverse conditions. It was a great privilege to receive the spurs of a knight before the Tomb of Christ, this being the reward for an exceptional act of piety. Throughout the whole subsequent period of the Latin Patriarchate's suppression, the right to create new knights was the prerogative of the representative of the highest Catholic authority in the Holy Land, the Custos. Custos, in this case, meaning a religious superior or an official in the Franciscan order. In essence, this would have been, in most of the non-Latin-speaking world, what was known as a custodian. In this context, it would be a high-ranking official, oftentimes a lesser nobleman, or the younger son of a baron, or potentially even a landed knight, who would serve the church in exchange for the perks of being in charge of a castle, town, or sometimes even a whole region. The custodian would typically have very limited decision-making rights, limited to mundane day-to-day organizational tasks and staffing concerns. Custodians would not maintain hereditary titles, nor would any offspring. They were also not entitled to the lands, tax revenues, and were usually paid a salary by the church for their services. The position typically reported to either the local baron, or in some cases, such as this one, high-ranking church authorities such as an archbishop or a cardinal. Shrapnel. In 1489, Pope Innocent VIII suppressed the order and ruled that it was to be merged with the Knights Hospitaller. In 1496, Pope Alexander VI restored the Order of the Holy Sepulchre to independent status. Alexander VI decreed that the order would no longer be governed by the office of custodian, and further decreed that the senior post of the order would henceforth be raised to the rank of Grand Master, reserving this title for himself and his successors. The privileges of the order recorded by its guardian in 1553 and approved by successive popes included powers to legitimize bastards, change a name given in baptism, pardon prisoners they might meet on the way to the scaffold, possess goods belonging to the church even though they were laymen, be exempt from taxes, cut a man down from the gallows and to order him to be given a Christian burial, wear brocaded silk garments, enter a church on horseback, and fight against the infidel. In France, King Henry IV of France purchased its French possessions and incorporated them into his newly established order of Our Lady of Mount Carmel, formally established by Pope Paul V through the Bull Romanus Pontificus on 16th of February 1608, and expanded through Militantium Ordinum dated 26th of February 1608, along with possessions of other orders which apparently were all deemed extinct and abolished, indicating reduced regional activity. Nonetheless, the dubbing and the privileges enjoyed continued confirmation by Pope Alexander VII on the 3rd of August 1665, and by Pope Benedict XIII on the 3rd of March 1727, and by Pope Benedict XIV, who approved all but the last of the privileges of the order, and also stated that it should enjoy precedence over all orders except the Order of the Golden Fleece. Pius IX re-established the Latin Patriarchate of Jerusalem in 1847 and reorganized the Order of the Holy Sepulchre as the Milites Sancti Sepulchri, whereby the Grand Master of the Order was to be the Latin Patriarch of Jerusalem, and the Order ceased to be a pontifical order for the period. Initially, the Sovereign Military Order of Malta opposed the decision and claimed rights to its legacy, probably based on the papal decision of 1489. However, in 1868, it was named Equestrius Ordo Sancti Sepulchri Hero Solemnitani, or the Equestrian Order of the Holy Sepulchre of Jerusalem. Pope Pius X assumed the title of Grand Master for the papacy again in 1907, but in 1928, this was again relinquished by Pope Pius XI in favor of the Patriarch of Jerusalem, and for a time, the order again ceased to be a papal order. In 1932, Pius XI approved a new constitution and permitted investiture in the places of origin and not only in Jerusalem. In 1945, Pope Pius XII placed the order again under the sovereignty, patronage, and protection of the Holy See, and in 1949 he approved a new constitution for the order, which included that the Grand Master be a cardinal of the Roman Curia, and that the Latin Patriarch of Jerusalem be the Grand Prior of the order. In 1962, the constitution of the order was again reformed and the order was recognized as a juridical person in canon law. The current constitution of the order was approved by Pope Paul VI in 1977, and it maintains those arrangements. The order's status was further enhanced by Pope John Paul II in 1996, when, in addition to its canonical legal personality, it was given civil legal personality in Vatican City-State, where it is headquartered. An amendment to the constitution of the order was approved by Pope John Paul II simultaneously with the concession of Vatican legal personality for the order. The order remains today an order of chivalry and is in association of the faithful with a legal, canonical, and public personality, constituted by the Holy See under Canon Law 312, paragraph 1-1, represented by 60 lieutenancies in more than 40 countries around the world, 24 of which are in Europe, 15 of which are in the United States and Canada, 5 in Latin America, and 6 in Australia and Asia. It is recognized internationally as a legitimate order of knighthood, headquartered in Vatican City-State under papal sovereignty and having the protection of the Holy See. The order's principal mission is to reinforce the practice of Christian life by its members in absolute fidelity to the Pope, to sustain and assist the religious, spiritual, charitable, and social works and rites of the Catholic Church and the Christians in the Holy Land, particularly of the Latin Patriarchate of Jerusalem, which receives some $10 million annually in donations from members of the order. Other activities around the world are connected to their original functions. In France, the French Revolution resulted in a ban on conserving relics and all other sacred symbols linked to the monarchy, though pieces judged to be of high artistic quality were exempt. These relics were handed over to the Archbishop of Paris in 1804, and are still held in the Cathedral Treasury of Notre Dame de Paris, cared for by the Knights of the Holy Sepulchre and the Cathedral Chapter. On the first Friday of every month at 3 o'clock p.m., guarded by the Knights, the relics of Saint Chapelle are exposed for veneration and adored by the faithful before the cathedral's high altar. Every Good Friday, this adoration lasts all day, punctuated by the liturgical offices. An exhibition entitled Le Trésor de la Sainte Chapelle was mounted at the Louvre in 2001. So, as you can probably tell, although many people seem to greatly confuse this knightly order with others, primarily that of the Knights Templar, this is a distinct organization that has maintained operation since the Crusades, primarily through charitable and religious works, but also a knightly chivalric order that one can still join today, albeit strictly through invitational appointment. In any case, I hope you enjoyed this video and found it to be informational and entertaining. If you did, I recommend checking out my whole series of history videos discussing various topics regarding the Crusade and those who partook in them. But that's all for today, so thanks for watching and have a nice day, and I'll see you next time.